Good morning, everyone. So glad that you were able to make it here today. It's crazy out, huh? We want to welcome you, and why don't you go ahead and stand? We're going to start worship this morning. We're starting with a new song today. It's called Firm Foundation, and it's so powerful. I love this song, and this morning as I was getting ready, I was reminded of the old song, on Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. I don't know if you remember that song, but this is our prayer today, at least in the prayer room today, was that all distractions in your life would go by the wayside today, that you would just come alongside the Lord today and have faith that He is a firm foundation today. So let's go ahead and start. Stand when everything around control what tomorrow will bring. But I know here in the middle is the place where you promised to be. I'm not enough unless you come. Will you meet me here? Jesus, it's on you, God, that we stand, your firm foundation. Jesus, I pray this morning, God, that your love will rise above every fear, God, that anyone faces today. Lord, you are more than enough this morning. And we just ask, God, that you would be with Stephanie as she speaks today, Lord. I pray, Lord, that our eyes would be open and that our ears would be clear to hear, God, your word this morning. We love you and we thank you, God, for just feeling, we felt your presence today, God. It was so sweet. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. The fourth through sixth graders can be dismissed and go ahead and greet each other. Try to greet five people.
Right. There we go. Hey, good morning. Thanks so much for being here. My name is Matt Portman. I'm the lead pastor here at Cornerstone, and glad you're here this morning. And we got to do something first. So if you fell in the parking lot, I owe you candy. So if seriously, if you fell, and I know Mandy did, so I apologize, Mandy. So if you're literally, if you fell in the parking lot, we're trying our best. Raise your hand. The ushers have candy they're going to bring to you right now. I'm serious. If you fell or slipped in the parking lot, they'll bring you candy right now. Jack's in the back. He's got candy. All right. So make sure Mandy gets, like, if you want to give the whole bag to Mandy, it's great. She'll have the whole bag. All right. But really, if you slipped or fell, please, I apologize. We're doing our best. It's like living in Indiana. It's like, you know, like snow and ice and all that kind of stuff. Why we live here, I have no idea. All right. So, all right. Hey, we're going to jump into a couple of quick things before Stephanie comes and teaches this morning. The first one is, if you're new with us, man, you're amazing that you actually showed up to church new on a really, really icy Sunday. So, but there's a connect card in the back of the seat in front of you. We would love for you to take that card out, fill it out sometime during the service, and turn that in at the Welcome Center on your way out, which is just right outside those doors, just so that we know you were here. Or if you want to, you can actually scan the QR code that's there and fill that on out online as well. That would be really appreciated if you could do that. And then also, while you're there, while you're at the Welcome Center, you can get a free gift, which I actually think they're pretty cool. There's a little tumbler there for you, a Cornerstone tumbler, so you can grab that on your way out as well this morning. And for every card that comes in, either digitally or in person, we give $5 to a nonprofit organization, so it's actually beneficial to other people as well. And then regarding giving today, we don't pass a plate here at Cornerstone, but giving to God is an important thing as a follower of Christ to do. And so trying to make it easy for you to do that. There are giving boxes on the back of the wall here in the auditorium, in the atrium, in the kids' hallway. We've also made a way online at yourcornerstone.church/give. You can text in, you can send checks in, all that kind of stuff. So there's lots of ways to do that. We'd appreciate you, and we do appreciate your giving to the church. And then wanted to let you know today is the last day. I know many of you will bring those in on your way in to bring in the food for the Pad the Pantry food drive that we've been doing. And I was given the number that we are just under 484 items have been donated so far to the pantry. Yeah, so give yourselves a round of applause on that. Way to go, church, on that. That's awesome. So we're going to actually divvy those up. A lot of that stuff is mostly going to go to the Mishawaka Food Pantry, which you know was actually shut down for a little while this last few months. And so they definitely need some help, so we're excited about that. And then a couple more things, just a reminder about our upcoming child dedication that's going to be coming up on February 19th. And so if you've man, we've had a lot of people have babies this year. So it was like 2020 and 21 and 22. Like, it was just one of those things where, like, people were just having babies. So we have lots of kids. We'd love to dedicate them. If you're interested in that, you got to go to one of these two classes, February 12th or February 16th. My wife and I will be teaching that class, and it's required to get your child dedicated. So you can sign up for that at yourcornerstone.church/events. And then the last thing for me, and then I'm going to be quiet, and Stephanie's going to come up and teach us this morning, is I wanted to remind you, a few weeks ago when I entered up the kind of throughout the vision for this year, I mentioned something that we're doing this year. We're going to hear quite often is take five to invite five. And the idea is to take a pack of five invite cards and invite five people to church or to your small group or to an event. We actually had an incredible event Friday night. Some of you were here for the trivia night. We had like 13 teams and like 80-some people here. It was awesome. And so way to go for those of you who invited people to come to church. That was great. But the idea is it actually only takes 5 minutes to invite five people. And so take, if you don't have a pack of these, pick these up. They're at the on the table by the couches. They're at the welcome center. They're at the coffee counter. But take some of these and invite people to church. Sometimes you never know what an invitation will do. It might actually change someone's life. And we would love that, by the way, because that's why we do what we do, is to see God interact and impact people's lives. So just wanted to remind you about that so you can grab those on your way out today. So that is it for me. Today, we are continuing our series, The Departure, and you all get the privilege of hearing from Stephanie Stanger. So give it up for Stephanie as she teaches us this morning.
Good morning. I'm Stephanie, if you haven't figured that out by now. So when Matt does intros, we get movie clips, right? When I do intros, so the worship team is going to lead us in another song. This song will be a time of reflection. So if you need to worship the God of the universe, you can go ahead and do that. If you need to just take some time to think and to pray, you can do that. And I would like to pray, so I'll be up in this corner to pray for you. If you feel like you are not enough in your current season, your current role, your current assignment, current mission, whatever it is, just come forward and I will pray over you in equipping over us. Because I often feel like I'm failing in this season of motherhood. So yeah, just come up and we'll just pray for that power. Why don't you guys go ahead and stand, and I'll say a prayer, and then we can all move, if that's standing, sitting, kneeling, or coming to the corner. Yahweh, I thank you that you do not leave us alone and powerless. And I thank you, too, that you don't let us get away with making excuses and taking the easy way out. I thank you that you pursue us, that you come after us, that you call us to be part of your amazing, beautiful plan, that you want to partner with us. Thank you for this community that you've put us in. Just want to worship you for who you are, for what you're capable of. And we just ask for your call to be very clear on our lives of what it is that we currently should be pursuing and striving after. I just pray that you would equip each one of us to seek you and to have confidence in your power. And I ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
stars burning up the night till heaven's open and we arrive in your presence, Lord, in your presence. Only a moment to live this life like shooting stars burning up the night.
I'm glad that we had a group over here, but my guess is there's probably more of you that need that prayer. So here's what I'm going to do. Steph, it's okay. Can I put you back over there? Because here's my guess. I appreciate what Steph had to share this morning. I appreciate that the story of Moses feeling inadequate. Whoa. But I'm so appreciative of stories like that because many of you know that I'm a pretty confident dude, but I will tell you that there are times when I'm by myself in my own head that I can feel like I'm not enough. And so if you still need to have this prayer this morning, I wanted to give you another opportunity. And there might be, my guess is there's somebody here that needs that prayer with Stephanie that didn't come up, so I'm going to just have Stephanie stay there for a minute. But some of you are going to go out and you're going to be done, but some of you, this is the prayer you need. It's the thing that has probably been in your mind over the last week and month or whatever. Like, you have felt this inadequacies. And even the places that God has called you to be. And here's my thought. What do you have to lose? Right? What do you have to lose? You might actually walk away with more confidence, because the reality is through conversation that Moses had with God, he had more confidence to go do than he led people through the wilderness. And so maybe this prayer, by the way, it has nothing to do with Stephanie. She had to claim that this morning, right? It has everything to do with God. But she's going to pray that heaven would come into your life, that you could feel more confident and know that you can be made enough by the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. So just want to make that opportunity available one more last time, okay? The other thing, that some of you, maybe that's not that, but you got something this week that you need somebody to pray for you. Our prayer crew would love to pray for you. Just come sit in the front row and they'll pray about anything going on in your life. Whether that's an emotional thing, a relational thing, spiritual thing, financial thing, whatever it is, they're very nice people, and they will pray. And so just come up, so they'll wear a badge, and you can just, they'll pray for you, okay? And then last couple things, Stephanie already mentioned it, but the ushers will have conversation questions to dig deeper into today's topic, and I think there's some really good, fruitful things to walk through that Steph put together, so grab those on your way out. If you don't have to rush out the door, man, I would love it if you would just hang around, get to know people, let people get to know you, live this whole idea of relationship at our core at Cornerstone. Super important, all right? And And then if you're new, I'll be out by the front door. I would love to shake your hand, say hello to you before you leave as well. And then I'll just reiterate, be careful as you head out the door. Don't fall. We didn't have a flamethrower out there, so hopefully that worked. I don't know. But be careful as you're going out today as well. All right. I think that's all I need to say, but I want to pray for you, and then you guys can respond, okay? So, God, I pray. If there are people in this room that you're not finished with yet, if they need to come up and receive the prayer with Steph because they didn't the first time, God, would you make them uncomfortable right now that you're talking to them and say, you need this, and that they would come forward here in a minute? Or, God, if there's other needs that they have, that they would come forward. They would not leave this place without somebody praying for them. Because I believe in the power of prayer, God. You've called us to pray. And I pray, God, as your church leaves the building today, because we know that the church is the people, it's not the building. We pray that you would go with us, before us, behind us, all that we think, say, and do. Keep us safe as we travel on the roads. But gosh, God, we just want to make Jesus Christ famous. Help us do that. Bring us all back together again next week. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Thanks so much for being here. If you're done for the day, you can head out and just kind of hang out in the atrium. If you want to get in on the prayer, have Stephanie pray for you, or the prayer crew, we'd love to pray for you right here. You can come forward. Thanks. Have a great rest of your Sunday, everybody.